Welcome to our module Sustainable Biopolymers. In today's lecture, I would like to introduce you to an EU-funded project from the Horizon 2020 funding scheme, where we follow up a novel route for plastic recycling. And it's called P4SB, from plastic waste to plastic value, using Pseudomonas putida synthetic biology. The overall challenge we discussed in the previous lectures. So there's massive amounts of plastic produced. We have the topics of waste management. If this is well done, it's less of an issue. We have recycling. We have reuse. We have incineration. But in entire world, we have also landfill and mismanaged plastic. In the worst case, in the open sea. If you look at the EU numbers, we have 30% recycled, and there indeed we should look at alternative technologies, especially if we look at the goals of the EU. For the PET bottle, we would like to increase this from the 30% to 50%, but already in 2020. This is hard to reach, but it's even far more difficult if we look at some specialty PU foams. Less than 5% are recycled, and the target should be 70%. In total, the goal is clear. We don't want to use the plastic with all the benefits, and then in the waste management, pollute the environment, in the worst case, harm sea life, enter the food chain, accumulation of toxic compounds. And so I would like to introduce you to possibilities to produce the polymers from alternative feedstocks. We discussed it before in a different lecture. First generation, now really established. We have sugar from sugar cane. We can use it from starch, from corn or wheat. And we do a fermentation steps, for example, and produce valuable bioplastic. This is entire in the food versus fuel debate, and so we would like to avoid this. We rather would like to use the straw in the second generation, and it's now coming up that we see some of the fermentation, especially for ethanol production. Again, we can use it in our scenario to make bio-PET from ethanol. In the third generation, we would like to avoid the competition, especially if we use maybe some side streams in the agricultural sector, maybe from forests, but maybe more directly aiming for algae and other CO2 fixing waste streams. But how about potentially truly alternative feedstocks? And that's where our P4SB project kicks in. And we would like to use non-sustainable plastic waste via an upcycling reaction to produce sustainable value-added alternative materials. So what do we really want to do? We would like to use PET and PU material, degrade it enzymatically. I will introduce you in a second to this technology, and feed microbes producing bioplastics. And this is your microbe, there's some bioplastics inside, and we produce here an interesting plastic foil, which can be used in very nice application. And ideally, this is even biodegradable. Which microbe can do it? Use plastic waste to grow on it and produce something of value. And this is our host, Pseudomonas putida, KT2440. It has a high tolerance towards stress. It has a versatile metabolism. It requires it to use the different monomers from plastic as a carbon source. It's a model organism, and it's generally recognized as safe. So it has GRAS status, and it's a known PHA producer. You may remember PHA is one of these bioplastics with high potential in the bioeconomy. And it can be of very high concentration. And here are some of the blobs of PHA inside a cell, and you see it covers quite some area in this nice picture. Our partners, where you see you require to do something like this, quite some technologies and some expertise. Our partners from Zurich in England are synthetic biologists, UCD, Dublin and Bioplastics, use plastic waste to produce with Pseudomonas PHA. Proteus is a French company in protein engineering and protein valorization. CSIC and Backmine are well known for the synthetic biology in Pseudomonas and PHA production. ADWTH Aachen, we are here in Germany. We are training the microbes to use these monomers efficiently to produce products out of it. Helmholtz Center and the University of Leipzig are included, focusing on PET degradation, University of Leipzig, and some of the specialties of PU degradation at the Helmholtz Institute. CNRS and Soprima are our polymer chemists, and Soprima are actually a PU manufacturer. Think about also the value chains. If the technology works, plastic waste to plastic value, how can we bring it to the market? So from an invention to an innovation. And this is the workflow. We start with plastic hydrolysis. So we have the plastic waste, we mechanically shrink it to flakes or powder, and then we use enzymes which can break the ester bond in the PET. And then you have the two different monomers. In PU, it gets more complicated. And in the second part, we use these monomers as carbon source for our Pseudomonas bacterium. In the third part, PHA production, then the bioplastic is produced, and then finally the PHA is removed from the cells. We do that via synthetic biology and model-based design, and we have, as all European projects have, a dissemination exploitation. And please visit our P4SB webpage, because there you see some ups and downs of explaining these technologies to the public. And it's an interesting endeavor, the dissemination and also the exploitation. Some technology on the molecular level. If you look at PET, you have the two monomers and you have this ester bond, and this can be hydrolyzed by PET hydrolases. We have different bonds in a PU. We can use particular hydrolases which can break some of the bonds, and we get a mixture of different monomers. And in the next step, we have to train the microbe that it can take up these monomers as a carbon source and produce biomass, grow, but ultimately we would like to recover the carbon and some of the structure of the exergy in the product. So we feed the microbe central carbon metabolism, and then some are via fatty acid de novo synthesis, hydroxy fatty acid, HAA, some specialties, but more importantly, our bioplastic intracellular, but we would like to remove it from the cell. And this removing part can be done by autolysis, and we actually developed in the P4SB project an interesting autocatalytic cell lysis protocol. And our partner CSIC, in a previous study, developed extremely, for me, cool technology using a predatory bacterium. Betulovibrio bacteriovorus grows on, feeds on Pseudomonas. So you have a Pseudomonas, then it's attacked by this predatory bacterium, internalizes, feeds on the Pseudomonas, eats it completely, and if you engineer this predator, then the only leftover is a bioplastic, which then lays around, and you can easily work on this and purify it for the production. So what did I present you today in today's lecture? The P4SB workflow from plastic waste to plastic value, doing an upcycling step. So we use waste streams, PET, PU, feed microbes, and come up with a biodegradable bioplastic, which is of higher value. And we use for this a Pseudomonas putida as a chassis strain, equip it with all the function required to use plastic waste as carbon source, and produce this valuable bioplastic, which is also biodegradable. With this, I'm at the end of this today's lecture. I hope you liked it, and see you soon.